And hello, everybody, and welcome to week four on the Coaches Perspective here on Riverside TV. We've had a couple of great weeks. The last 2 weeks have been phenomenal for RCC football, where they've gone to, they're undefeated so far in this early year. And we've had some great high school football games. But before we get into it, let me introduce to you my partner, my friend in the booth, the great Gonzalezon. How you doing, buddy?
Geoff, great to be back. And yeah, another fun weekend for us.
I'll tell you what, we had a great one this past weekend. Saturday night or Saturday afternoon, we had a matinee where RCC really completely dominated Long Beach City College. And wow, they look like they are on pace to almost eclipse that national championship team from 3 years ago.
Yeah, and the interesting thing, Geoff, is you can tell that RCC isn't really up to speed. They're very good, but I know Coach Kraft and the staff thinks they can be better. There's some rough parts they need to still sand out, but how good did they look? I mean, this is a Long Beach team that put up 72 on LA Southwest. They came into Ramona High School on Saturday, and the Tigers dismissed them without much incident.
Yeah, and talking about a great start to the season is a transfer from Golden West. The great, which Retzlaff brother do we want to mention? Both of them have been fantastic. Reggie Retzlaff and Jake Retzlaff, phenomenal games through the first two. The quarterback has been great, throwing 11 touchdowns and 900 plus yards. How phenomenal is that in just two games?
Yeah, they're a handful, and Brett Peabody, who is the head coach of Long Beach City College, and Geoff, they've been very good. And that's been a very good team over about the last seven, eight years. And he told me on Wednesday, he said, "Hey, we've seen the film, and we need to hem in Retzlaff and Juwan Tucker. Those guys are threats on the outside." Well, Reggie Retzlaff caught two TD passes. Tucker caught two. So of the passes, of the five TD passes, four of them went to the two guys that Long Beach City was focusing on. And they got some dudes in the defensive backfield. That just shows you how good Riverside City College is.
I'll tell you what, Coach Kraft does a phenomenal job every single year. They're 30 players down this year, and it doesn't seem like they've missed a beat, does it?
And I think the one thing that doesn't get mentioned enough, and we've been covering you and I for about 3 or 4 years, RCC, is the tremendous job that their defensive coordinator, James Cook, does. No matter who's on that defense, and they cycle guys out, they send guys to Division I, they have guys playing at USC, among other places, they have guys playing at Rice University this year, and he figures out the formula defensively, whether, you know, the first week they had a little bit of a rough start. He was playing without a couple of starters. They still got the job done. And then this week, I think they forced four turnovers against Long Beach City, who's a pretty potent offense. And they made their quarterback, who looked flawless in week one, have all kinds of trouble in terms of the varying coverages and the pressure they were able to put on him.
Yeah, in fact, three interceptions, a hat trick from DeMarco Moore, the great, just made his debut this past week. Boy, he is something special. We can't wait to see him play this year.
I mean, he's going to be an impact player for RCC all year. Jalen Carter as well. And then those corners, you know, Tom Kraft wasn't sure about the cornerback position. He's like, "Hey, we're not very deep. We've got a lot of different guys. People need to step up." And they've been stepping up the first 2 weeks.
Yeah, well, we're going to have them again. They're going to play at Saddleback this week. They'll be on the road for 2 weeks. We'll be back in 3 weeks. We'll have them on the schedule for a 2 o'clock game.
College of Canyons will be the opponent. It'll be interesting to see. They also have another high-flying offense, so let's see what the Tigers' defense can do against the Cougars.
And let's go back to the Friday night game. That was the big one. Everybody was talking about going into it, and that was Martin Luther King versus Riverside Poly. It was a packed house, but I'll tell you what, King is doing what they're supposed to be doing. They're winning ball games, and they're winning pretty convincingly.
Yeah, King was the better team. I do think, though, you know, Riverside Poly, although they, you know, the score didn't look great, they hung in there despite being very, very undermanned, particularly in that first half. And King, I think, came out, you know, Coach McMaines had a couple players didn't start due to coach's decisions. So Coach McMaines trying to establish the culture there at King. They obviously won. They got the job done when they needed to. But I think Poly also exposed some vulnerabilities for King. They just weren't whole enough. They weren't complete enough on the offensive side to complete them. I thought the defense was okay in the first half for Poly, and then obviously they made some mistakes that hurt them. Both teams made mistakes, and I think when John Rice and Jason McMaines go to the drawing board this week, they're going to see, "Fellas, You guys are fine. We need to clean up these mistakes. Penalties were one. Drop passes were another.
And talking about going into the fire, you know, they play a tough King team this past week. This week, they got to go against, you know, arguably the best team in Riverside, and that's the Ramona Rams, and they're putting up some big points.
Yeah, a friend of mine told me that Ramona Poly is the real rivalry in Riverside because they're the two oldest schools. But I agree with you. It looks like right now, and we're about a week from league play starting, that Ramona and King are probably the two best teams in Riverside right now based on-field performance.
Yeah, and Friday night's game, we're going to have a doubleheader. We're going to have the big rivalry, like I said, Ramona versus Poly. And then on the other hand, the flex game, Pep Fernandez and I will be on the call for that one. And that'll be a good one. That's Deshaun Burns at Linfield Christian versus Ken Batdorf over at Norte Vista High School. That will be a definitely a chess match, to say the least.
Yeah, by the way, don't tell Ken Batdorf that Ramona and King are the two best teams, because he'll get upset because he thinks his Braves should be in that conversation. Now, maybe they are. We don't know yet. But as far as on the field right now, I think King and Ramona have definitely performed well. But, you know, Kenny Batdorf and the Braves, they do it every year. They do it consistently. They don't surprise anybody. They just continue to win, 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 and win.
Well, they're a young team, and he's back to his smash-mouth ways. He has given up the pass for the rest of the year, and let's see if anybody can stop him, especially in the River Valley League.
In years past, you know exactly what Norte Vista is going to do, but they're still able to be successful because of how they execute and how they run that system.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, we've got a couple great games this week, and you're not going to be on the call with us. You're going to be working at the UCLA game this weekend, doing some big work behind the scenes. We're going to miss you, buddy.
Taking the week off, it's good. We'll step away for a little bit, but I'll be back. I'll be back the week after. It's just a one-week respite. You get to work with Pep. I think that's good.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you what, it's always working. It's always a pleasure working with you, Gazal. You're my man in the booth. You and I call all the games, and we're looking forward to seeing you next week on Riverside TV, buddy.
It'll be refreshing to step away for a weekend, but I'm looking forward to being back with you in some great games this week. I'm really interested to see how that Ramona Poly game plays out, Jeffrey.
Well, it's going to be a good one. We're going to have it as Nick Rice and J.R. Ibarra will have that call at 7 p.m. on Riverside TV. He's Gazal Hassan. I'm Jeff Gorham. When we come back, we're going to be joined by the head coach of Ramona High School, Ken Mashinsky. And we are back here on the Coach's Perspective, and we're joined by my favorite coach in the area. He is the head coach of Ramona High School. He's the great Ken Mashinsky. How you doing, Coach?
Good, good, Jeff. Thanks for having us on. Just real excited to get this homecoming week versus Poly started and get the game going Friday night.
So wait a sec. The homecoming, this is a true rivalry, and you guys are having homecoming against Riverside Poly is what you're saying?
That is what we're saying. Yeah, I think it's great to have, you know, there's a lot of good Riverside schools around here and good Riverside coaches that we all get along. And it's great having a Riverside school versus a Riverside school as your homecoming opponent. And it was week five. It was a home game for us. It set up perfect right before our bye week. So yeah, we're fortunate. We get to have another Riverside school for our homecoming.
Well, I'll tell you what, you couldn't ask for a better school to play against. No offense, and I don't mean this in a bad way, Riverside Poly. My parents went there, or my dad went to Poly, but I am a Ramona Ram. I wore my bright blue shirt today just for the occasion. No offense, Coach Rice and the Bears, but Ramona High School, you guys are playing the Bears. What do you think about the Bears so far this year?
They're a very, very talented team. You know, I always talk to the kids about a rivalry week. I don't know if Poly thinks that Ramona is such a rivalry, but definitely Ramona has a disdain for Poly over there. And our kids get up for this game. As a rivalry, you know, you kind of have to throw everything out the window. It doesn't really matter what the records are, who's healthy, who's not. It's a rivalry game. It's you know, two Riverside schools going at it. Riverside Poly is very talented, obviously led by number five, Tajon Henderson. He's a stud. He's a good running back, plays DB. So he's a very good player. They have an excellent coaching staff over there with, you know, Coach Rice and Coach Powell and a host of others. Very good O-line and D-line. Not as big as they've usually been, but very, very disciplined. Good tacklers, and they play so low and aggressive. So it's going to be a great game Friday night. We're really looking forward to it.
Yeah, Coach Rice, they played King this past week. They were a little undermanned. They had some injuries. The injury bug hit him, but you mentioned Tajon Henderson. What an outstanding athlete. And he can cause some problems from just about anybody.
He does, and both sides of the ball. He's such an efficient runner. He's elusive. He's fast. He has very good vision. But, you know, people forget he plays on the defensive side of the ball, and he makes an impact over there. He's just a very, very good athlete, and it's going to be great to be able to play against him on Friday.
Well, Coach, you guys have started off the year great. I mean, the only loss you guys suffered was a tough loss at Kaiser. Billy Cardosi does a great job over there. But, man, you've played a gauntlet of a schedule. You guys start league next week. How are you feeling going into league? Everybody healthy? Are you guys feeling excited about getting into the River Valley League?
Definitely excited about getting into the River Valley League, like always. You know, I really get along with the coaches in the River Valley League, and it's fun to go and battle against each other. We kind of had a preseason where we tried to set everything up as you know, playing running teams like Kaiser, Temescal Canyon, because we know that when we play Novi and Patriot and Arlington teams like that, they're going to grind it out. So we wanted to get ready for it. You know, fortunately, last week we played Temescal Canyon, who has just a heck of a quarterback in Ko'opana, but he was injured, so they had their backup in. We were able to, you know, take advantage of that a little bit. Offense kind of clicked. Defense put up a goose egg. But the previous, you know, couple games before that, like playing Kaiser, playing North, we definitely set that up to practice for that run. So when we do face those, you know, those double wing teams, those double tight teams like Patriot, we already have a little bit of experience. You know, we're very similar to Hillcrest, very similar to La Sierra. So our scout teams and our offense and defense have seen that a little bit. But we don't run against a double wing team or a double tight team all the time. So it was very important that our preseason, we set some of those games up. Definitely looking forward to Friday. We're not gonna count that out. But, yeah, definitely, you know, looking forward to River Valley League. It's always fun.
Yeah, and the River Valley League's really been a big surprise so far this year. Patriots a lot better than we've seen. La Sierra's better. Arlington, who, you know, went to the state finals last year, they're better. And, of course, Ken Battendorf, who has promised me he is not going to throw again all season long. He's going to go double tight, and he's just going to smash mouth it in. I'll tell you what, all the River Valley League teams, they've all improved, I think.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. And I said this, a month or two ago, when I found out La Sierra had three levels, a freshman, JV, and varsity, that really was a true telling that, you know, the River Valley and high school football in general, I think it's kind of back on the map. I was talking with Chris Fowler, the head coach and athletic director over at Patriot, and he was saying that his numbers were up about, you know, they had 120, 125 kids, which is great for Patriot. Just like Ramona, we have about 125, 130 kids. I know Battendorf over at Novi, he has three levels. So everybody in our league has three levels, and it hasn't been like that in quite a long time. So, you know, you may say, oh, it's kind of a surprise the River Valley League is doing so well. I don't think it's a surprise. I think that we have six great teams in the River Valley League, and it's going to be a bloodbath. And if you know, take your foot off the gas pedal or just kind of go into a game thinking, this is going to be an easy win, that you're going to get snake bitten a little bit. And it's going to be a great River Valley League. I don't care what Battendorf says. You know, he says all these things. It's going to be a good one. There's some good teams and some good coaches and some great players. It's going to be a fun 5 weeks heading down the road.
Well, Ken Mashinsky, we are going to have the game Friday night, the rivalry game, Ramona versus Poly. It'll be at you. Is it at your place?
It is at our place, yeah.
That new, nice new turf. Everybody's going to have a great time. But I'll tell you what, Coach, it's always a pleasure having you on the Coach's Perspective. You always do a great job, and looking forward to seeing you Friday night versus the Riverside Poly Bears. He's Coach Ken Mashinsky. We'll be right back on the Coach's Perspective here on Riverside TV. And welcome back to the Coach's Perspective here on Riverside TV. And oh, this is a doozy. I'm bringing on my mortal enemy, my confidant, my friend sometimes, my enemy most of the time, Ken Battendorf. You have a game coming up Friday night, and we're going to see the Braves for the first time. You guys are going to battle Deshaun Burns and Linfield Christian. Hey, tell us a little bit about the Braves. You guys started off pretty good so far this season.
Well, actually, we started off pretty bad. We lost our first game, and then we won the last two. First game, we did a lot of young mistakes. We're a really young team, youngest team I've ever had, and we graduated 19 seniors, and that's going to happen. So we're, you know, playing a lot of young kids, inexperienced kids, and game one, we made a lot of those mistakes, and hopefully we can keep fixing those as we progress.
Well, Coach, you know, first of all, I'm going to say congratulations on that 200 wins in 87 years of coaching. Is that what it is? Or is it, I'm sorry.
Hey, that's, what's a year?
So 29 years or is this 30 years?
29. This is my 29th season.
29th season, 200 wins. Congratulations, Coach. I mean, that's a great accomplishment. You and I always mess around, but man, I mean, that goes back a long ways. That's success in one spot. How do you feel about that?
You know what? It's the head coach is only going to be successful if he's got great kids and great coaches. And I've been truly blessed to have both. I mean, I could go back to my first year and I had David Plenihock Sr., Henry Hernandez, Jeff Otterson, Eddie Mercado, Ishmael. I mean, I could keep going. I remember every kid on that team. And I had great assistants. I had Scott Albertson, who's just a legend. Ron Main was there with me when I first started, you know. Ed Jones, unfortunately, passed away, but I've been so blessed with great coaches, and every few years, they all move on, but I get lucky. I get great guys after that. It's same about kids. We get hardworking kids here, and I can't say enough about the great kids we get.
Well, I heard Moses was on your staff at one point as well, so you've been there a long time.
Well, you know, Moses was there, but he got in trouble for hitting people with the stick. So Richie took it.
Well, Coach Batdorf, you know, we're going to talk a little bit about Linfield Christian. Deshaun Burns, what do you think of that guy as a coach? We've been around him, and he's just a bastion of knowledge.
He is phenomenal. I love the guy. I really got a chance over the last few years to get to know him. As far as watching his kids execute, they do everything right. I mean, they may not be as big as other people, but the way they carry the ball, the way they tackle, the way they move, their schemes. And I've told them this many times. It's just fun to watch his team. They may not win, but they're going to come out and do things really well. And it makes me a better coach to watch a guy like Deshaun because he does the little things right. He holds his kids accountable, and they do a great job. So, you know, for me, it's fun to watch it.
Now, Coach, like you said, you lose 19 players off of your squad from last year's team. You've been successful, and I mean this genuinely. You've been successful as long as I've known you, which is a long time. And coming with a young team like you have, what adjustments have you had to make with such a young team?
Well, you're part head coach, part big brother, part grandfather, part dad, school psychiatrist at times. We got it all going on. And it's not like it was 25 years ago, 29 years ago, where you just yell at everybody and they do it. You got to take a kid aside, put your arm around him, talk to him. As you know, we feed our kids every Tuesday. They're just finishing up eating right now. And we do that one, you show your kids you love them. And I don't think we ever talked like that 30 years ago. You show your kids you care. That was what was important. Well, now it's got to be a little bit more. And if you show the kids that you love them, you care about them, not just as football players, but as human beings, they're going to do better for you.
Well, Coach, tell us about some of those young guys. I mean, we haven't heard of these guys yet. We've always heard of the Eddie Elaines, the Freddie Hollies, the Molesio brothers. Give us some names of some of these new guys that we're going to be hearing from the next few years.
Well, we have a couple seniors. DeMarion Richardson's really kind of did a great job offensively and defensively for us. He is a senior, and he's kind of from the same mold as that group. You know, real physical runner. He's only about 170 pounds, but he runs like he's 200. He's done a great job. And even though the line's not like it was, because we're starting four sophomores up front, I never hear him complain. And you got to love that about a kid like that. He knows he's had better lines, but he's the senior sitting there just, you know, encouraging him, working his tail off. So that's a big spot. We got a guy named Brian Teppel, who's never played high school football before, and he'll run the wrong way and score. So it's like, Brian, you went the wrong way, but you scored a touchdown from 70 out. So go ahead and do that when you want. And up front, we got some young guys like Ryan Rodriguez, who will be special when it's all said and done. He got a blindside call, excessive blocking. When he took a kid from Western Christian and drove him about 25, 30 yards, and then pancaked him. And I'm like, the play was still going. But coach, it was excessive. I don't know what that means, but I'll take it. But we have other young kids up there doing a great job. Kevin Rayo is our center. He's a big kid. Ryan Hurtado, big kid. They're all young kids doing well. We have one senior up front, and I can't say enough great things about Eddie Villarreal. He was our tight end his sophomore, junior year, and we had a huge need to tackle. And here's a kid who's caught the ball and just been a great leader on our team. Going, coach, I understand. And he moved from tight end to tackle, and that's really made us better. So every week we're going to get better. You know, and I realize there's those practices where we take a step back because maybe we try to put too much in. And you got to go back and make sure you master something first.
Well, coach, just like you tell your players, I love you, coach. You're a great guy. You're a good friend. Everybody always questions me, do you and Batendorf get along? I always say, no, of course not. But we really do, and I appreciate everything you do for the students at Norte Vista and what you do for the city of Riverside. I appreciate it. We all do here at the city of Riverside. Thank you so much, Ken Batendorf.
Oh, it's my pleasure. And as I said, when you do a job like this, because we have all kinds of different problems, it's more of a calling. It's not necessarily, hey, I get to coach football, which I do and I love. I get to work with young people to make them better. And in the end, that's what we're supposed to be doing. And yeah, I want to win football games along the road. But if I got, you know, like we tell the kids, if you're successful in 10 years, you're a great father and husband, and you have a good job and you're happy, we did something right. And I think we as coaches have to remember that. I may win 10 games, but if my kids are out there in 10 years and they're tearing up society and not being contributors, I did something wrong. So there you go.
Well, Ken Batendorf, we will see you on Friday night. Pep Fernandez and I will be on the call. We're coming out of retirement. The Inland Sports team is coming back to call your game, and we'll have it Friday night as you battle Linfield Christian. He's Ken Batendorf. I'm Geoff Gorham. We'll be right back on The Coach's Perspective. And we are back here, my favorite part of the show, where I get to visit with my best friend in the entire world, the great Pep Fernandez. How are you, Pep?
Oh, man, I am all fired up. Listen, I'm fired up every single week for high school football in the great city of Riverside. But this week, I get to sit next to you, Big Jeezy, Geoff Gorham, and call an awesome game between Norte Vista and Linfield Christian.
Well, I'll tell you what, we had a battle it out. It was between Marietta Valley and King and Norte Vista Linfield. The vote went out. Norte Vista won the voting process, and this is our first flex game of the year, and you and I are going to be on the call. It's going to be great. I can't wait. I'm going to bring popcorn. I'm going to bring candy. I'm going to bring my highlighter and a couple sheets of paper. We'll be ready to go.
Listen, as long as I got a highlighter and maybe like an iced coffee, man, I will call any game next to you. But, Geoff, here's the funny thing. I just had Coach Batendorf on the Inland Sports Show, and I told him the same thing. Hey, City of Riverside, Riverside TV, doing a cool new thing where they let the fans vote who they want to see. So I call him the homecoming king. He's Mr. Popular. He won. People want to see more Ken Batendorf, and then he got the most votes.
It's like more cowbell, more Ken Batendorf. He just think of it this way. Ken Batendorf just won his 200th game. That means he's been coaching for as long as Moses has been on Earth. He's back in the golden ages. Before football, he was coaching.
So let's see. Let's do some math. He's been at Novi. Is it almost 30 years? Like, how many years has it been?
I think it's 29 years.
So that's about 7 wins per season. So let's say he went 7-3 every single season he was at Norte Vista. Can you imagine going 7-3 every single season? That's a playoff team every single year, basically, if you do the math and average it all out.
Yeah, and he has a young team. We talked about a little bit about it when we had him on the show. A young team, And I'll tell you, there wasn't a lot of expectation going into this year, but they're starting to get some momentum. There's a little snowball effect going in, and I think the Braves are going to be pretty good, and we're going to actually get to see him against one of our favorite coaches, Deshaun Burns, and Linfield Christian, who's always a formidable opponent.
Yeah, in fact, Ken Batdorf called or compared Deshaun Burns at Linfield Christian to like an artist. He's like, man, have you seen the plays he draws up? He's like, it's like art. He's like, you just sit back and kind of enjoy it. He's like, it's so cool what he's doing. He's just so creative and artistic in what he, you know, the schemes he likes to run. So he thinks, at least on paper, you know, this is going to be a good matchup because he knows, you know, Deshaun Burns will have his team ready and they're probably going to throw some unique things at the Braves on Friday night.
And you know what's going to be unique, not unique about Norte Vista? They're never going to throw the they're never going to throw the football. Pep, we're going to be out of there by about 8:30. We'll be able to go get dinner with Coach Batdorf and Coach Burns and be able to go watch the rest of the games. How fun is that going to be?
Listen, we knew, obviously, we knew they were going to run the football, but now they've got actually two great running backs, and this kind of happened by accident. We know Richardson, he was kind of like the starting running back, and this other guy named Temple. So Coach Batdorf said, you know, he put him at receiver, and he just, this was his words, he couldn't catch the football. So we're like, let's make him a running back, and he's averaging like 20 yards per carry now. This guy's insane. So you've got Temple and Richardson, and you got this Damon Iosefa, the big guy, is like a fullback. I've been doing my homework on the Braves, and I'm like, oh, yeah, they are definitely running the football again. They got some great running backs.
Hey, I will say this. Damon Iosefa has the best hair of anybody I've ever seen.
Best hair, and the guy is huge. Like, I think he looks like a defensive lineman, but he can run the football too, I guess.
Well, we will see him on Friday night. Pep, when is the Inland Sports Show again? Is it tomorrow night, Wednesday night?
Wednesday night, 6:05 p.m. We will have Coach Batdorf on the show as we really break down this Riverside TV game, the flex game that the fans voted for to see the Braves and the Lions. So we'll break down that game. And there's some surprise teams around the Inland Empire having great seasons as well. So we'll talk a lot. In fact, it's going to be all high school football on Wednesday night.
Well, Pep, it'll be you and I Friday night. We're going to be in the booth. I can't wait. It'll be like old times. It's going to be great. Pep Fernandez, always thank you for joining me on the Coach's Perspective. We will see you on Friday night. Get there early because I'm telling you what, we're going to be taking pictures, kissing babies. It's going to be great.
Well, they call you the mayor in some circles, right? In the sports circles.
In some circles, I've been called the mayor. Well, he is the president, Pep Fernandez. I'm just the mayor, Geoff Gorham. Thank you again for joining us here on the Coach's Perspective. And Pep and I will be there Friday night, Linfield Christian, Norte Vista, Riverside TV Game of the Week. We will see you then. Thanks, Pep. We'll see you on Friday.